Today we'll talk about chewing, the benefits of healthy food chewing, and how to chew food properly. I guess we all know that we need to chew food diligently. It's good for health. At least this is what my grandma told me many times when I was a little boy. But I would like to use this video as an opportunity to highlight the key benefits of healthy food chewing and remind all of us that healthy chewing is a critical part of healthy digestion and overall health and fitness. And it's the holiday season that comes with a lot of food and a lot of chewing. So I hope this video will make your holiday meals healthy and more enjoyable. And I believe in the power of atomic habits, when small incremental changes in everyday routine compound into massive, huge improvements in overall health. And proper chewing is one of those atomic habits, simple but super efficient one. So let's talk about that. Hi, Andrey here. Welcome to the Practical Health Channel. This is where I share my learnings and personal experience with improving health. Think this way. The digestive tract is a 9-meter-long pipe that starts in the mouth and goes down through the body. And chewing is the very first step in the food digestion process. And doing it properly brings a lot of benefits to our health. Benefit number one is, I hope no surprises here, better food digestion. The logic here is quite simple. By grinding and chewing food, we increase the reaction surface area of the food, upon which enzymes can act. It helps nutrients get digested and absorb more easily. The other thing is that in the mouth we have salivary glands that secrete amylase and lipase. So starches and fat start getting broken down in the mouth. So proper food chewing helps start digesting starches and fats in the mouth before they go to the stomach. And finally, chewing sends signals to the pancreas, gallbladder, stomach to start secreting enzymes necessary for food digestion. So proper food chewing gives us more time to send signal to those organs to get prepared for the coming food. The next benefit is my favorite one. Proper chewing reduces the chance of overeating. It takes about 20 to 25 minutes for the hormones to reach the brain and tell it that the stomach is full. So proper chewing gives us enough time to let the brain realize that the stomach is full, when it's really full. The next benefit is related to mouth, teeth, and the mucus of the GI tract. When we chew, we secrete saliva that helps moisturize the oral cavity, the esophagus, and the food itself. And also saliva contains EGF, or epithelial growth factor, that is critical for the mucosa of the GI tract. Also, saliva neutralizes bacteria on the teeth to keep them healthy. And finally, chewing itself is a great massage for the gums. The last benefit on our list is related to mental health. Chewing stimulates the hippocampus in the brain, improves learning, neurogenesis, and synaptogenesis. Also, chewing reduces the levels of corticosteroid plasma, a stress hormone, and increases the levels of serotonin, one of the four happiness hormones. So we can say that chewing reduces stress and makes us happier. I guess a lot of people can relate to that. Now the big question is, how do you chew food properly? Step one is to take smaller bites. Do this by using smaller plates and smaller spoons, which is a proven way to make sure that you take smaller food bites when you eat. Step number two is to chew food diligently, up to 32 times per bite, or until it becomes a soft paste or liquid. I don't have any specific recommendation or suggestion here, besides use a couple of your meals to count the exact number of times you chew your food. It will give you an idea how far you're from this number. The next one is quite straightforward. Keep your mouth closed when chewing. It will reduce the amount of air that you swallow when eating. Air in the stomach negatively impacts digestion and may cause abdominal pain and bloating. The last two steps belong to the same category. Here you can slow down your food intake. One idea here is to swallow before taking the next bite. Basically, don't mix one bite with another one. And the other idea is to simply eat slowly. And I have a couple ideas here. One is try to really enjoy your food. Focus on the food on your plate. Your steak, your salad, whatever you have on your plate. And try to enjoy it. Also, some people use their food intakes as a time to socialize with other people. An opportunity to connect with their family members, friends, and co-workers. It's another way to have healthy breaks between food bites. Again, remember that it takes 20 to 25 minutes for the stomach to send signal to the brain saying it's full and stop eating. And that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Remember to chew food diligently and eat slowly. I wish you have healthy and enjoyable holiday chewing. As usual, if you like this video, give us a like. If you don't like it, subscribe to our channel. One day we'll create a video that you love. See you next time. Bye.